Hi all, and welcome back to our World of Warcraft Warlords of Draenor Let's Play. Yep, as you can see here, look at that, we got a little molten corgi here, and it's because achievement, World of Warcraft 10th anniversary, logged in doing World of Warcraft 10th anniversary. As you can see here, it is the 21st, but oh my god. He does the same as the Perky Pug, where he sits down and rubs his ass on the ground. But because he's a molten corgi, he burns up where he scratches. it looks like he takes a goddamn dump, but it doesn't, because it just he just scratches his bottom, and yeah, pretty cute. That Perky doesn't do. But yeah, he's a molten corgi, so I think that is the third dog in our pets thingy. And let's see, we got the molten corgi. Let's just pick him down here. Let me just go up here. P-U-G. P-U-G. Perky Pug and Beethoven. I think these are the three dogs. I think these are the three dogs that are in World of Warcraft at this moment. Yeah, real dogs, not the special ones like this one. I don't know if you can call that a dog. And then there's the Corehound Pup. I don't know why, but Corgi is a real dog. We have Corgis in real life. We don't have a Corehound Pup, so Corgi. Molten Corgi. The Perky Pug and Beethoven, the Alterac Blue Pup, Perky Pug and the Molten. Let's give him a name, shall we? Rename. We have Beethoven, Flat-Faced Butt-Nut. What's Corky? What should we call the Corky? Wiener dog, the wiener dog. Or if you want, you can write something in the comments below if you want me to name him something else. So yeah, I don't know what came over me coming up with a flat faced butt-nut. I have no idea. Oh my god. Yeah. So, today is actually upgrade day. We are upgrading the inn to level 2. Also, ow. Upgrading the gem boutique and the forge to level 2. Yeah, not this one. I'm thinking. Wait a minute. I'm pretty sure we are upgrading. Yeah, we are upgrading the flower boutique and the fishing place to level 2 as well. I'm pretty sure. Let's go in and have a look, shall we? And yet, still, I have not yet. Gotten the town hall. Let's go in and have a look at a lecture here. Yeah, we are upgrading these two to level 2, but you can't see it. I don't know why they haven't the same as the gem boutiques and the Lunarfall in like construction on them. They just don't. Okay, here we need level 100. In order to get level 3. unlocks access to an additional large, medium, and small building plots, and grants access to 3 custom mounts. What, 3 custom? Ah, cool. Yeah. So another large, another medium, and another small. Yeah. Then comes the trick. What are we gonna take for? I'm actually thinking of this one. This one is pretty good because you can gain in scraps, and with having a forge, you can use those scraps to build items. Even also. Oh no, that's the wrong one. Sorry, that was the bunk I had on there. Here you go. You can also gain items to your followers, meaning you can upgrade your followers' items. That's pretty cool. Even the armor, you can upgrade a new armor transmogrification as well, and items for your followers. And also here, look at this number 3. One out of my 3 seals of temporal fate. It's like the road. You do a road roll in the raids, and you get a boost with these seals and stuff like that. And you can either get money or epic new items or some stuff like that. But one of the seals out of the 3 I have, each week becomes a free one, meaning I actually. I can actually gain a 4th one. You only get 3, but I can actually get a 4th one every week. What the heck is this? Whispers in the darkness. It's in a. Whispers in the darkness. It's a, apparently a legendary quest. Find the void gate key in the Shadow Moon burial grounds. Okay. Cool. As you can see, I am. I'm low on money. I had 5k yesterday, and I've spent it on buying blueprints. Cost quite a lot for these two: 1,000 a blueprint and 700 and 50 for these 3 each, plus the gold cost of upgrading them. Well, so I'm thinking of the dwarven bunker for the next number 2, the medium. I'm not sure if I should go with lumber mill or the barn. Allows you to capture cliffhoof, elkin, wolves, and talbog for leather and fur used in leatherworking and tailoring recipes. Yeah, I don't know if I'm gonna use that. Increases your out of combat regeneration, meaning when I'm out of combat, I regenerate health much faster. In outdoor Draenor zones, and allows the collection of broken bones from defeated enemy players. That's PvP, and I'm not that much into PvP. So, the trading outpost. I'm getting all the stuff that I need from my mine, and also from the flower shop, and yeah. So no, it's gonna be the lumber mill, hands down the lumber mill. Okay, we got the gem boutique, we got the forge. The next small one could either be the storehouse, which allows me to have my own bank in my in here, or the salvage yard, meaning the items I get from this, the scraps. Let me just see here. Stables, mage tower, nope, it is the dwarven bunker. Armor scraps, yes. Salvage yard, allows salvage to be missions. Oh yeah, this is the one I actually was thinking about when I was doing the dwarven bunker. Great, as you can see here, number level 3, greatly increases your chance to recover salvage from missions. In addition, you may also discover player items in salvages. And also here level 2. In addition, you may now discover follower items. So yeah. Either that or the storehouse enables access to your personal bank and increase the total amount of active workers work orders for all buildings by 5. Enables access to your guild bank. Enable access to the ethereal traders for void storage and transmogrification, and increase the total number of active work orders for all buildings by 15. Okay. Whoa. This is just salvage and missions and stuff like that. We're gonna go with storehouse. That's exactly what I'm gonna do. We're gonna go with storehouse. Enable me to access my bank and stuff like that. That could be so awesome. And even guild bank and void storage and transmogrification, so I don't have to go anywhere. Nice. Okay. Yeah. My game may jitter a little bit. It's because I'm rendering and uploading at the same time. So yeah, I'm really, really pushing my internet and my computer to the max right now. But it seems like it's coming along quite nicely even. It's not that much it jitters, but it is a little bit. Nice leather shoulders. Five resources slot. Spell power, lol. Mana regeneration, nada. Oh my god. Currency, that's what's the one I wanted. I still got 19,000. 800 something of these timeless coins, and 644 of these lesser charms. Damn, yeah. I went with all of the gear I had on here. I realized that I more than half of them I could upgrade. As you can see there, upgrade level 4 out of 4. I could upgrade them, right? I went from I think it was 555 item level to 569, what I have now. Pretty damn cool. Okay. Oh, wrong one. Yeah, we have 2 quests we can do out here. So let's go get them. Your first Wardogger. Let us help this guy. He seems a bit. Do we have 5 2 iron ore? This is what I hate. I'm trying to help a guy out and he just completely ignores me. Let me see here. Thank you. Oh, why can't I? I'm supposed. As you see, it's a bit jittery right now. Ah, that's how it was done. I had to click on my portrait. Now you learn that too.
There. See you later.
Never forget, never surrender.
Nice. This one should go away as soon. Yep, there we go. 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute, 2 minutes. Sweetums. Lol. Oh, P.S. You're on YouTube. Okay. Let me see, I think so. Yeah. Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. No, shit, sorry. Not Wednesday, Tuesday. Lol. Blizzards hate walking. Try spell it backwards. N E G R O W. Negro. Yeah, okay. That was, let me just see here. Is it? Yeah, that one's almost finished. Also got that one up. Yeah. Sorry about the tearing thing, but shit happens when you have to Nice, that was one shard. Next shot is up here. Hopefully he spawns soon. Awakening? Bam! I love it when you do the one-hit kills. Damn. Hello? It's down here somewhere. Ah, there it is. Yoink. Gotta love it. Wham! The bigger the weapon, the bigger the smash. Okay. My guess is I have to go up here somewhere. There's probably someone. Fucking hell! Anyone for Spires of the Betrayer? Unless a warlock. Yeah, he was lesser, that's for damn sure. Fucking hell. God damn bloody fucks. Well, how you doing? How you doing, Khadgar? Of course. Yep, he's right over there. Go one fiery heart. That's a little bit too goddamn easy. Yeah, I know.
Quickly, combine the shards to forge a soul trap for Gul'dan.
Maybe I should do it in here. nice looking cloak, but still not as good as the one I have.
Be careful, my friends. Rodan is not to be underestimated, no matter how prepared you might be.
Do you see me sweating? I'm not. Yeah, Gul'dan's supposed to be right here. Come on, Gul'danio. Come on. Looking for group heroic. I am DPS. What kind of DPS? Rogue? Whatever. Hmm? Where have you seen this statue before? Isn't that one of the guys that's at the Blackport? Well, I'm gonna wait here for Gul'danio, and yeah, as soon as he comes out, we're gonna take him down. But until then, we're just gonna skip over this waiting part, so see you there. And we are back. It only took a second or so. But yeah, here we have Gul'dan and here we have him. So let's target him and let's...
I am not that easy. Resume your task.
No!
Have fun dealing with this.
For the Burning Legion?
Do give my regards to Khertgar. I've a present coming for him.
Go. Done and done. Let's get back to old Khertgarian. Khertgar's image. And yeah. Let's tell him what Gul'dan told us, I hope. That he should be wary. of a apparent incoming present from that. Shut up, phone! Yeesh. Yeah, from Gul'dan. And what means Spectral Tiger Mount? Actually, the Spectral Tiger is a bit overrated. Even now, where loot cards have stopped being made, the Spectral Tiger Mount is still, like, costs like 5 grand or something like that. Goddamn.
Together, Commander, we will defeat the Shadow
Don't
Council.
Let the Archmage down.
Knowledge is power.
Oh. Oh yeah. Wait a minute. You haven't seen this part. I can show you this part now. Sorry, I forgot you haven't seen this part.
Rise, old friends. The time has come for the next step of my plan. Terengor, infiltrate the Orcini and take control of Arkandun. Lead them dry. It will be done, Lord Gul'dan. Cho'Gall, we'll finish your Frostfire business together. I'm sending you to Nagrand to subjugate the Naru and Ashogun. I will crush it.
The Pale are the key.
All I require is its limitless power. Razun, you stay here. I have other plans for... What is that? What are you looking at? It's all for dreams. Until...
Yeah. That's what started this whole quest thingy over here with Gul'dan.
Observe and reflect.
Come back in 1 minute. Whoa, we get something new.
Commander, what's wrong?
Khadgar, someone's here.
Assassin! Coward.
Gul'dan sends his best.
I knew it. You should have stayed back at the garrison, Archmage.
Nonsense. I had that handled cool as a cucumber.
Yeah! You were in a freaking ice cube! I love that he does that. They do these small, funny things. No. The reason is... She...
I don't trust this place.
She has a crush on him.
Don't let down your guard. Learn here.
Nice.
Be vigilant, friend.
Okay, yeah. So, thank you all so very much for watching. I'll catch you on the flip side.